In this video, we'll guide you through connecting the ITNC series controller to a lithium battery and setting it up to improve your off-grid power safety. This is a basic off-grid system using a 48-volt lithium iron phosphate battery from EPEVER. We need to connect the battery to the controller using a communication cable. Note, the lithium battery communication cable is an optional accessory, so be sure to obtain it in advance. And for other brands' lithium batteries, a protocol conversion module is needed. To get the best performance from the controller, we suggest using EPEVER batteries. Let's get started. Firstly, connect the end labeled BAT to the RS485 communication port of the lithium battery, and then plug the other end into the BMS port of controller. After confirming all connections, turn on the battery switch and set DIP switch 1 to the on position to activate the required function. Wait for the controller to power on. Typically, there are three main settings on the controller: battery type, BMS protocol number, enable BMS control parameters. Now, let's walk you through the setup process. Press and hold the controller settings button to access the settings menu. The first page displays the BT settings. Press and hold the settings button once more. When battery type AGM starts flashing at the top, it indicates that the battery type is ready to be set. Press the down button several times. Stop when LiFePO4 starts flashing. Press the settings button once to set the battery type to the 15 series lithium iron phosphate. The reason for setting 15 strings is that each cell string has a voltage of 3.2 volts. 3.2 volts multiplied by 15 equals 48 volts, which matches the voltage of the batteries we are using. For more information about batteries, please check out our previous video. Note, the battery type must match the one you are actually using. Next, configure the BMS protocol and activate the control parameters. Press the up button multiple times. Locate the UES interface. On the screen, the UES indicates whether the battery management system control parameters are enabled or disabled. The default setting is off. Turn it on. Press the up button once. Access the BPRO interface. This is used to configure the BMS protocol. The default is 32. Change it to 10. Note, batteries from different manufacturers may have different protocol numbers. The controller and battery can only communicate properly with the correct communication protocol. 10 is the standard protocol for EPEVER batteries. Do not confuse it with others. Once all settings are complete, return to the home screen where the BMS icon will appear on the controller display. The controller and lithium battery are now in normal communication. To optimize battery usage, we recommend setting the battery charge and discharge mode to SOC and enabling the lithium battery protection function. These settings can be found in the CDM and LBP interfaces, respectively. After making the changes, restart the device to ensure all settings take effect. The ITNC series solar charge controller features a built-in BMS management module, offering a variety of advanced features for you to explore. For detailed instructions, refer to the user manual provided with the device. Be sure to read it carefully before use. Connecting remote temperature sensor and configuring ITNC series controller. For lithium batteries, temperature compensation is generally not required. But when using lead-acid batteries, it's essential to add a remote temperature sensor so the controller can monitor battery temperature in real time and enhance system safety. The remote temperature sensor is an optional accessory that communicates with the controller via a standard RS485 cable. Be sure to obtain it in advance. Let's get started. First, connect one end of the communication cable to the BMS interface on the controller and the other end to the temperature sensor. Then, attach the temperature sensor to the battery using high-temperature double-sided tape. Power on the battery. The remote temperature sensor collects real-time battery temperature data. The key settings, battery type, charge and discharge mode selection, and BMS protocol configuration. Let's get it. Press and hold the controller settings button to access the settings menu. Press and hold it again and set the battery type to FLD. Note, users should configure the battery type and control parameters based on the specific battery in use. Next, set the charge and discharge mode. Press the down button repeatedly to navigate to the CDM screen. Then set it to UO, voltage compensation. Then, using the same method, navigate to the BPRO interface and set the BMS communication protocol to 32. Note, as we are using a temperature sensor to protect the battery, a separate number 32 communication protocol is required to connect the sensor. Please note the difference between this and the BMS protocol when using it. Once the settings are complete, restart the device to apply the changes. The controller gathers battery data via the temperature sensor. If the battery temperature gets too high, the controller will promptly cut off charging to prevent potential hazards. When the battery temperature is too low, the controller also provides effective protection. In addition to this, there are many other options available for viewing and setting in the controller's parameter settings interface. We encourage you to explore freely and discover all the features. Remember, the abbreviated parameter names on the device are fully explained in the user manual. As part of regular maintenance, we encourage performing periodic checks to ensure the temperature sensor is still properly attached to the battery. If you have any questions while using the device, please feel free to contact us.